A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 17th June, on the front page you have Bhutan PM says China must maintain status quo on Doklam. So this is regarding the Doklam crisis which we had discussed few days back too. It is actually a standoff between India and China and which actually Bhutan was involved. So Doklam is actually a plateau in the northeastern region in which is claimed by Bhutan, and Chinese presence has been there. China had initiated construction activity and had brought construction equipment, machinery near the region, and India protested on behalf of Bhutan. So this actually resulted in a standoff. Both armies were standing on the region and the situation was tense. So eventually the standoff ended. So Doklam region is important for us because it's also close to the Siliguri corridor, so the chicken's neck as such. So now Bhutan has given its statement. It says no side should do anything near the tri-junction point unilaterally. So this is statement by Bhutan Prime Minister. Then below you have now eco-friendly flats for members of parliament. So the buildings of North and South Avenues in Delhi will be constructed using fly ash and waste bricks. So this is first round of redevelopment of flats for members of parliament which is taking place, and these are eco-friendly houses where fly ash and waste bricks are being used. Then on page 9 you have Pollution Board seeks explanation on dead fish in Maharashtra rivers. You can see the number of dead fish which have been found, and Maharashtra Pollution Control Board will take action if villagers fail to explain why around 4,000 fish were found dead. So it will send collected water and fish samples for analysis. So results will be out. And below you have Goa move to promote casinos for tourism opposed. It is said gambling is against public policy and is prohibited by law. So an umbrella body of women's collectives and other groups are fighting casinos as such, which Goa government proposes to set up in the state for tourism. And this is drugs of 18 pharma firms found substandard since 2018. So this is Bureau of Pharma, PSUs of India. So it bars firms from supplying to Jan Aushadhi scheme. So this is the central government's flagship scheme for affordable medicine, Pradhan Mantri, Jan Aushadhi scheme. So they have found 25 batches of drugs of 18 pharmaceutical companies to be of substandard quality. On the editorial page, the first editorial is a different tent. So this is regarding Shanghai Cooperation Organization Summit, SCO Summit, which took place in Bishkek, Kyrgyzstan. So where India and Pakistan, the Prime Minister of both the countries also participated. It's an 8-member grouping, India and Pakistan being the latest entrants, with even China and Russia being members here. So it talks of how SCO has become vital to India's Eurasia policy. And the second editorial, Missing Remedies. So this talks of how West Bengal CM must reach out to the doctors and an upgrade of public health care is vital. So we are seeing doctors protesting. It started off in West Bengal and has spread to all across the country. Even Indian Medical Association has called for a nationwide strike today. That's mentioned on the front page too. We have discovered that earlier, so no need to cover it again and again. But yeah, this editorial talks of how there's a requirement to reach out to doctors because their safety is a concern for them. A doctor in West Bengal had been, a young doctor had been attacked, and such instances have been seen earlier too. So the editorial talks of how West Bengal CM must reach out to doctors. And of course, a public healthcare upgrade is essential too. Then this is the Gujarat model nationally. So this Lalit article talks of how the 2019 outcome is proved that Gujarat model is scalable at a national level as long as it has a charismatic champion. So the way BJP won elections in Gujarat has been done at the national level too. That is being spoken of. So it says minorities have been made to live in fear by those who believe in vote bank politics. So this is Prime Minister Narendra Modi, which has told the newly elected MPs of National Democratic Alliance, among whom members belonging to BJP command a clear majority in the present Lok Sabha, the 17th Lok Sabha. He says that we have to end this deception and take everyone along. Then below you have, in the absence of good law. So this is regarding public procurement. So public procurement means government procurement. So government has various PSUs and it also requires procure goods, etc. So how public procurement takes place, there is a policy in place. But then this article talks of government should pass a law, an act on public procurement. So actually what happens is whenever tenders are awarded and public procurement takes place, the petitions are filed in the Supreme Court. So recently the Supreme Court expressed its growing concern over the award of tenders being challenged in writ proceedings almost as a matter of routine. So this actually becomes a nightmare and hindrance in governance as such too. So that's why this article talks of how there is no legislation and there is a need for a law in place. On the op-ed page you have this article qualifying for leader of the opposition. So again, who will be the leader of the opposition is the question. It's actually leader of the opposition according to the Act of Parliament of 1977. It says that at least the leader of the opposition should have 10% seats in the Lok Sabha, which is not being satisfied presently too. So that is why now it's leader of the single largest party in opposition should, its leader should become the leader of the opposition. So that is what this article talks on. On page 12 you have PM calls for one nation, one poll. So this is again regarding simultaneous elections, which was a point raised by BJP earlier too. And now at the governing council of the Niti Aayog, he spoke to the leaders or chief ministers of various states, all the states, and he says, let's keep differences aside and work for nation's progress and move towards one nation, one poll, one election. Then below you have Enforcement Directorate says that aviation pacts hurt national carriers. So deals were struck between 2005 and 2009, which helped UAE, Qatar gain more seat entitlements and airports. So this is the allegation by Enforcement Directorate that substantial jump in seat entitlements and Indian points of call, airports as such, for the operations of foreign airlines took place due to bilateral agreements struck between India and UAE and with Qatar too, between 2005 and 2009. So this resulted in huge losses to national carriers. Then on international page you have Hong Kong protesters seek leaders' exit. So we have already seen in Hong Kong the extradition bill which was being opposed has been suspended. But now you can see that there are protests still going on in Hong Kong and they are demanding Carrie Lam, the leader of the or the chief executive of Hong Kong, to exit. So demonstrations have continued. Because she insisted, she's considered to be pro-Beijing and she insisted on passing the extradition bill which would have allowed any Hong Kong national to be who was arrested to be extradited to Beijing, with which there is no pact as such and human rights concerns were raised. Then below you have Ghana's free high school program earns accolades as well as brickbats. So enrollment has increased in the Ghana's education program, free higher school program, but then it has also seen infrastructure being inadequate. So this is a coverage on that. Then on Mondays you have business review coverage. So here you have a coverage on auto sector, automobile sector. So it shows how the number of two-wheelers as such which are sold, motorcycles, scooters, and these are cars, and passenger vehicles which are sold. So here you can see the growth of each section, passenger vehicles and two wheelers is shown, how passenger vehicles have taken a dip, even two wheelers, though it marginally increased in May 2019, and this is how their share prices are also falling. And here you can see the growth shown for two wheelers and passenger vehicles over the years. Then here you have, this will be a tough budget to balance. So presently the new government would be would be laying down the budget. So Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman, it is said, has an unenviable task of pushing growth while maintaining fiscal discipline. So we need to maintain fiscal discipline too, means government should not be indulging in a lot of borrowing, and we have to push growth. So for pushing growth, money has to be put in the economy. So both things have to be balanced. And this is, sugar industry needs a shot of insulin. So it is said current year is expected to end with high closing stocks of 14.5 million tons, metric tons. So the sugar industry urges government to facilitate higher exports. And on the last page you have, G20 agrees to tackle ocean plastic waste. So the group of 20 environment ministers agreed on Sunday to adopt a new implementation framework for actions to tackle the issue of marine plastic waste on a global scale. Japanese government, it is said, after hosting the two-day ministerial meeting which took place in Japan, it offered to lead the world in efforts to reduce trash. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aashar.com. Thank you.